Welcome. This is from the Egypt Country Office. What we did in response to preparing a presentation for you all was to make sure that we included the voices of as many staff as possible and have the chance to tell you exactly what they think about the changes in the New Egypt. We have four questions that we asked everyone. One about the feelings that they experienced during and after the revolution here. A second is, what are the remaining or current problems and challenges that still children face here? A third is what they can do as individuals, family members, or as employees of Save the Children about them. And the fourth question is something related to support that the Egypt Country Office would need from some of you listening to this right now.
Egypt is very, very good now.
What's happening in Egypt now is huge change.
It's the New Egypt. This is how I can see it.
The New Egypt is happening, and what's happening now, I think it's like a dream come true.
What happened was something that nobody dreamt about even. It was something very, very new to all of us. We didn't expect it.
I think about the revolution as was an inevitable thing. I just know that it was a long-term dream for my children to see, but I was so lucky to witness myself.
Dream that would come to reality for our children and our grandchildren, actually.
Of course, we all here at Egypt are proud from the revolution we did. And we hope the coming days will be better than last.
The educated young people of Egypt were the ones who drove all this change.
A hope for better Egypt.
We don't have something to lose.
Nobody knows where this is going. And we hope it will go for the best. And we'll try to work for it.
There are many challenges facing us now. And we have to be very patient and flexible in adapting new things.
The New Egypt, I'm afraid of the security issue.
Election, the new government, the new president, the stability of the country.
I see that the most big challenge that we may face in the next few years is the readiness for us for democracy. Even if we are not ready for democracy, it will be at some point.
I'm afraid to go out at night.
I think the challenges that it can face is a political conflict between the different parties. I think we can overcome it by more conversation and dialogue between the different parties, through the media, the newspaper.
We hope that with time people will learn new skills, will learn how to ask for their rights more peacefully, know what they want, understand what's going on really. And this is where I think that organizations like us can help.
We'll try to promote more programs that can help and provide better access for high quality education, health and livelihood in New Egypt.
I think Save Children can focus more on the marginalized communities.
Opportunities for new donors.
Spread our work towards New Egypt, not only Upper Egypt and Lower and everywhere in Egypt.
Help and support the health policy making rather than just help implementing an outdated one.
We are looking forward to spread our words and our mission to save more children in Egypt.
Reach every children all over Egypt.
And, the country office will write proposals on building skills and capacities of youth on how to accept the other, how to demand for their rights, how to engage with their communities, and try to help Egypt in this new transition to have a more positive behavior, you know, among all members of the community.
All of us make a good thing for Egypt, and not for Egypt only, for all of world. Obama says that.
We the support that can be helpful to us from the area or from home office.
Shendrin, nice.
Let us hope the best for New Egypt.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.